My dear friend, my name is Pastor Felix Opoku-Jemfi, pastor of the Ghanaian Seventh-day Adventist Church in Australia. Are you troubled? Are you worried? I come to you with some hope to help enlighten your path as you go through this life's struggles. There are surprises in this life that makes even the seemingly well-rooted people unable to find their feet. We live in a world that is so much uncertain about our tomorrow and our future. And because of this, I have put some statement together and I say it, that I don't know what tomorrow brings, but I know who brings tomorrow. And because I know He who brings tomorrow, I would want to entrust my life into the hands of He who brings tomorrow for a better future. Because in Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 7 it reads, "Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord." Psalm 112 verse 7 also reads, "Such a person who trusts in the Lord, he will not be afraid of bad news, for his heart is unshaken, since he trusts in the Lord. He alone knows what will happen to us tomorrow." And as we got into this new year, I want to entreat you to always trust in the Lord with all your heart, so that your future will be brighter. There are times we struggle to make sure that our future is better. But I always say, as Paul says, if it is in this life alone that we have hope, then we are the most miserable of all in this world. Because if all there is to this life is to work, get a good job, make a family, get the most expensive car you can buy for yourself, then it is the most unfair thing for us to strive for, because all these things do not last. Even where it lasts, we will outlive it. And because of that, I want you to understand that the only way by which we can make our future better is to trust in the Lord. If you are in a state where there's so much pain in your heart, there is something I want you to also take note of. The Bible says, "They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall walk and not be weary." There is one thing that every Christian needs, everybody who is prepared for heaven needs, because Revelation says, "Here is the patience of the saints." God normally takes us through situations that helps us to develop that attitude of being patient. Only those who can wait for the Lord can make it to heaven. So no matter the pain you have, Jesus has never forgotten you. He continues to call you and to care for you. Except that He wants you to get a little patient of Him. Just as He didn't tell us when He's coming. It is so much of a surprise to many people. So He doesn't tell us when our troubles will end. But He has said in John chapter 16 verse 33, He says, "I have told you this, that in this world you have tribulations, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world." It is in the victory of Jesus that we have our victory. We may have little victories here on this earth, but the maximum and the ultimate victory will come when Jesus appears. By this, I want to invite you to attend church, to worship with us. It is a family of wonderful people. It is called the Sydney Ghana Seventh-day Adventist Church, based in Sydney, in Australia. We worship in Maryland, and the address will be on your screen. But in case you want somebody to talk to in times of your difficulty, you want real pastoral care, you can give a call with the number that will also be on the screen, and we will come and listen to you and pray with you. It doesn't matter your denomination, we are here to help and to serve as the Master has told us. So I pray that as you continue to worship and to visit us, we will all join hands to have fellowship and to have the blessings of God together. May the Lord bless you. May He keep you. May He make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Until we hear from each other once more. Abe fajen, akorin chen.